Welcome back to another episode of Hello, Ladies, where feminism meets pro wrestling. We are your hostesses with the mostesses. I am Sabrina.
And I'm MJ.
And it is a predictions week, children. Gather round.
Oh, God. And if you'd like to gather around full time, make sure to give this video a like, follow us, subscribe on all platforms, and leave a comment below because today we are going to be talking about Full Gear. So this is our predictions for Full Gear. So drop in the comments below what your favorite Full Gear match of all time is. What's yours, Sabrina? I'm sure it's the Hangman Swerve Texas Death Match from last year, right?
Oh yeah, there's nothing more than I love than copious amounts of blood splattered everywhere. That's my fave.
Yeah, I think of you when I think of it, to be honest, you know?
To be fair, several people do, but
That's true.
it's to mock me.
They're so mean to me.
My sincerest hope is that my favorite match for Full Gear is about to happen.
Oh, I wonder what you mean, Sabrina. Which match could that be?
Well, we will
Do
get into that, MJ. But
our shirts have anything to do with
maybe I have like the
it?
weirdest Orange Cassidy shirt, but I mean, it's two dogs kissing Orange Cassidy the cat, so.
I love it. That's great.
Not bad. I will also be seeing Full Gear live, so I'm very
Yes.
excited about that as well.
Also, for anyone who hasn't seen those advertisements right now, there's actually a deal going on where you can get a bundle where you can get World's End and Full Gear now. I think it's like $85, so you can save yourself like $15 by just getting it early.
And AEW has their issues, but their pay-per-views are always banging.
Top notch. Banging.
So we'll start out. I actually have, so as always, this is the little caveat, of course, to doing predictions for AEW, especially this is we're filming this on Tuesday. So I'm sure. We are sure that tomorrow and throughout the week, more matches will be added. So this is
Yep.
the card as of 5 hours ago. So I do have the 0 hour, which is Costco Guy AJ versus QT Marshall. Who you got and what?
Did I send you the diss track that QT Marshall posted about that? I almost posted it and was just on my stories and was like, why? What is this? But I like took it away because I was trying not to be negative, but I was just like, I don't know. Like WWE had MGK, Jelly Roll, Kelsey, you know, and I'm just like, all of this cool shit. And I'm just like, but this is what we get right now, you know? Like, I love having celebrities in corporate. I think it's funny. I think it adds like something, you know, and it gets people talking about it, right? Like, as much as like Logan Paul is the most frustrating human being on the planet, he can go in the ring. He does bring eyes to the product. You know, WWE has that. AEW has not done that, right? They had Mike Tyson there once. Like, what other celebrity didn't Shaq go to AEW once, like back in the day?
Yes,
Yeah.
he did. So who do you got winning that match?
Which one were we talking about?
A Costco guy AJ versus QT Marshall.
Oh God, it's oh my God. That's so weird too, because QT left the company a few months ago and then came back because Costco guy wanted to have this match. I guess I'm gonna say QT, but like I feel like I could also see Tony putting the Costco guy over, to be honest with you.
I'm in the exact same boat as you on that, as is
Yeah.
Cheddar.
Cheddar.
Cheddar's in QT's corner, but just because he doesn't know who the hell the Costco guy is.
I don't know why that was so funny.
And QT recently did RJ City's What the hell is it called? AEW, and was entertaining. We were entertained, so
When did that one air? I don't think I've seen it.
might have been this week or last week.
Oh, okay.
It
Okay,
was
I'll have to
very
watch
recent.
it.
Very recent.
I'll look it up.
Okay. Next up, we have the four-way match for the AEW Tag Team Titles: Private Party versus the Outrunners versus House of Black versus the Acclaimed.
I don't think Private Party's run is going to end this soon. I'm going to say that they're going to hold on to it.
That is my hope as well. I will say I like that the Young Bucks are not in this. I like the Young Bucks, but
Yeah.
I think the tag division needs to stand on their own for a while without them in the mix.
Yeah. I will say that there's a part of me that could see the Outrunners taking it because they're so hot right now.
Yeah, they are. And I mean, Julia's coming back soon, so like, could she interfere and something with the House of Black happen?
Oh, okay. I like that. I like that.
Yeah. And the
I
Acclaimed
like
are
that.
always a solid bet. So, I mean, the only reason is because Private Party just got those titles. But Tony Khan sometimes is a prick and keeps titles on people for a short period of time. So anything's possible.
I feel like MXM is going to also interfere at some point in this because we had like the whole thing with the Acclaimed and them last time, and they've kind of had like a little bit of things with other tag teams, you know, so I could see them kind of sticking their nose into this somehow too.
I love MXM so stinking much. Their new line just dropped.
Oh God. Yeah, I love them too.
All right, and then we have MJF versus Roderick Strong.
Now, did Adam Cole, I don't know, I didn't watch Collision yet. Did Adam Cole lose that match? Because remember, it was like first to get to three gets to face MJF. I know Roddy's locked in, but if Cole won his third match, he also got to go against MJF. I don't know if that match has taken place yet, though.
No idea.
Okay.
Actually, I mean, again, this would he either lost that match or it hasn't happened yet because he's not on the card yet, and this is 5 hours ago, so
Right. Okay. So then Collision wouldn't matter, but Dynamite might. I'm not sure who. Takeshita and Adam Cole faced off last week on Dynamite, which was a good match, if you saw that one. It was good. It was pretty good. You know what? I really liked this. I know we're not talking about Dynamite right now, but I feel like you would really like last week's Dynamite because the pacing was just like on point. It was like with my ADHD, I was just like, this is awesome. Because it was like one match would end and then like they'd scoop the guys out of the ring and then they'd run the next crew out. And I was like, this is great.
I just didn't have time last week. I had three presentations Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Like last week killed me. So,
Yeah. You've been pretty insanely busy though the last couple months, so.
yeah. So I haven't watched a full AEW show in probably a month.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Crazy.
I feel
What
so
about Doug?
terrible saying that too. I feel like a fair weather fan.
You've been so insanely busy. No, you should not feel that way at all. You love wrestling more than like most people that I've like ever met, you know?
I appreciate that, as does my bookshelf.
You're a real fan.
Right.
Let's see. But yeah, that match, that's how I feel about the tag match. What's the freaking guy's name? I always forget. Remember he came out on the last pay-per-view? He was gonna marry Billy and Chuck, or like he convinced in WWE, remember?
Oh, Rico.
Okay, I was gonna say Rico. Yeah. I'm just saying that would be kind of funny if he came out again.
For which match?
The tag match.
We're not talking about.
I'm sorry, my ADHD is popping today.
Okay.
Which match are we talking
MJF
about?
versus
Oh,
Roderick
Cole
Strong.
and Roderick Strong. Sorry. You're like, why would Rico come out?
Yeah.
This?
It's just like, is he managing MJF now? Like, what is this?
Plot twist, he was the devil all along. Oh,
He's
God.
pissed because MJF took credit, or not MJF.
Okay, Mike, I this feels so bad because I didn't watch Collision because they would have at least given an update, right? Of like, and then on Wednesday, Cole just needs to beat so and so or whatever. That would have triggered my memory, but I didn't watch it. So I feel like I don't think that Cole has lost that third match. So I think he's still in the running to go against MJF. So I almost want to say Adam Cole would win, but I also like could be completely wrong and maybe Adam didn't win. I don't know.
I feel like if Adam Cole is added to this match, I
See,
kind of.
now I feel like a fair weather fan because I'm sitting here like, is Adam Cole gonna be in this
You've watched more than I have, so I feel like in a three-way like this, it favors MJF. Because the like, oh, the friends are going to go against him, and then
Or did Takeshita win against Adam Cole? God. I'm going crazy right now. I'm just gonna say MJF's gonna win. What's your call?
that's what I was. If it's three people in the winds up being three people in this match, I think MJF will win. If it's one-on-one, I think Roderick Strong will win due to interference.
Interesting. I have the opposite take. I think if it's just Roddy and MJF, then I think MJF wins. But if it's three people, I think Cole wins. I think I'm screwed everything up, and I think maybe Takeshita beat Adam Cole on Wednesday. My brain is just like, bloop.
To be fair, I think if Takeshita did anything like that, you would remember it in great detail.
I think that was the day that I had to work that long event, though. So I think my brain might have just been like,
What pretty man won? Ma.
what do men want? Maybe I'm just too broken up emotionally after finding out that Adam Cole and Britt Baker are Splitsville, you know?
Possibility, possibility. All right, up next, we have Bobby Lashley versus Swerve Strickland.
Bobby Lashley.
Yeah. It would be weird to have his debut on pay-per-view, him lose.
Yeah. I already think it's weird enough that Shelton Benjamin lost already. Like, I feel like they could have dragged that out. I don't know. It felt weird to me.
Yeah. Well, it looks like Shelton is in no better standing than he was in WWE.
We'll see. We'll see. At least he's getting to be on TV.
Yes, for now. Jay White versus Hangman Adam Page.
It's tough.
This was the hardest one for me.
Yeah, I'm stuck. When you first said it, the first thing that popped in my mind was Jay White. So I'm gonna go Jay White.
I went Jay White as well. I mean, he's back from injury as well. And I don't know, I'd like to see him go on a tear.
Oh, hell yeah. Me too. Long overdue. Long overdue. And I feel like Hangman's character right now is so badass and cool that like if he loses, it's like nothing.
Sorry, Cheddar just jumped at Dobby and hit the crate, which made me jump. And yeah.
I didn't even hear it. That's crazy. I saw you look, but I
Yeah.
didn't hear anything.
Acting up over there. Okay. Then we got Will Ospreay versus Kyle Fletcher.
Gonna be Will.
I agree.
Kyle's already gotten his licks in, you know?
Yeah. Did you see, like, there was an interview where Kyle Fletcher said he doesn't think that a gimmick like the Undertaker's could work today in today's wrestling because fans wouldn't buy into it.
Interesting. Do you remember where the interview was at?
I want to say Chris Van Vliet, but I don't know for sure. Don't quote me on that.
Oh.
My personal view on that is there is a like there are gimmicks like that that are working currently, like
Yeah.
PCO in TNA. The House of Black, Julia specifically, like the witchy magic.
I think, or like when Bray was alive, obviously, right? You
Yep.
know? Like the Fiend is the biggest one. I'm wondering if they mean from like if Kyle means more from like a social media perspective, because I feel like Kyle personally really balances that out well. Where like because he is like the bad guy, but he still is like lighthearted enough on social. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Nick Wayne does a decent job at that too, being like I've noticed he's on social, he kind of toes the line a little bit more where he doesn't post as much fan stuff as he used to because people have so many Nick Wayne fan pages and stuff he used to post when he was a face. So my mind kind of goes to like that, like because Undertaker was so strictly kayfabe that, you know, like especially if you're a little kid watching it, you know, or like 10 or whatever, and maybe still go on social media, you don't have like that to bridge
Like
the gap. You can,
MJF.
yeah.
I mean, that would be also like that way. MJF it like holds that line pretty hard.
That's true. That's true.
But yeah.
Yeah.
I was just like, sir, when I heard that, I was like, there in the three big companies, including the one you're in, I can think of examples like without putting much effort into it. Are you drunk?
Yeah. Yeah, I hear what you're saying. My only thing was like the paranormal element of it, you know? Kind of. You know, because
I
like
mean,
Bray still broke that when he went out of character, obviously, because he still was doing signings outside of being the Fiend and stuff.
PCO doesn't, though. I mean, he's Frankenstein. He's the Canadian Frankenstein, and that's just what he does.
Yeah. I don't know. Now I gotta look up that interview. I know it wasn't CVV because, you know, I would
You
be all
would,
over that.
yeah.
Yeah.
On to the next. For the TNT Championship, we have Jack Perry versus Daniel Garcia.
I think Garcia could take this.
That's where I'm at too.
I feel like it's been kind of weird the last couple months with Jack. I feel like at first he was kind of on a tear and then it just kind of like
It's like a lot of things in AEW.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on right now. It's so frustrating.
I think there's a drunk monkey in the back end. They're spinning the wheel. Maybe Tony Khan hired Vince as a writer, and that's what we're seeing happen now.
What about both Vinces, Vince Russo and Vince
I would like to unleash hell on earth.
McMahon? Well, Sabrina and I were just talking about this too, but today, because like she mentioned before, this is getting filmed on a Tuesday. AEW released their holiday schedule because her and I were scratching our heads trying to figure out why the hell Collision had gotten canceled, you know, and why there weren't any upcoming ones scheduled. There's going to be one in Phoenix, February 19th, but it's going to be at a venue that only holds 5,000 people, which is crazy.
Yeah, and then there's like three AEW slash Ring of Honor tapings or shows at the Hammerstein Ballroom in New York, which is great, except like I've been there for Comic-Con stuff before, like to see the Angel panel. That's where we were. And that was able to fill it. So it's not the biggest venue. I mean, it's steeped in wrestling history, but it's not huge.
Yeah, I mean, in AEW's defense, they've been paying a lot of money just to have very empty venues that cost a shit ton, like stadiums and stuff, you know?
Agreed.
So I
Agreed.
get it, but it's still hard to watch from where they were to where they are now. Like,
Yeah.
somebody was talking about when it was just rumored that CM Punk was going to debut in AEW and they sold out the United Center, you know? And then, I don't know. It's frustrating, you know?
Yeah, and it's not the talent's fault.
Yeah.
They have a strong roster. They could have a very good product. They've had a
Yep.
very good product before.
Yeah, absolutely. Even before they had a CM Punk or an Adam Cole, even, or Danielson, as much as I love all these big names, they had a great product before they started pulling in the bigger former WWE names, you know?
I think they might have done a little too much of that, quite honestly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's why you, that's how you piss people off, you know? So, I'm preaching to the choir
Yeah.
here.
And this is not like for anyone listening, like neither MJ or I are like, we want AEW to fail. Like, absolutely not. We both want them to succeed. And
Yeah.
everyone succeeds when there's multiple like high paying arena showing a
Yeah.
like wrestling shows.
Yep. And AEW is my favorite promotion, so it's very like frustrating for me, you know? So I'm feeling it. So we're not being tribalistic. We're just expressing our frustration because we know how good it was and how good it could be and should be.
Especially going into this next match, that's so far the only women's match on the card. The TBS Championship match, Mercedes Moné versus Chris Statlander. Yeah,
I'm gonna mix it up just to say stat.
that's not mixing it up because that's what I'm saying too. I
Well, damn it, Sabrina. How come anytime I try to be contrary to you, it's like my flame brain is still on track with you?
know what'll do it. I'll say one of her favorite female wrestlers is going to win. That'll get her.
Oh man. Listen. If that were the case, then I would have said Mercedes Monet.
Yeah. Yep.
I think that Mercedes Monet could have a comeback. I'm waiting for it. I feel like it could happen.
It's weird to say that though, when she's a champion. Like, how
Yeah.
often do you hear that, like, oh, this champion could have a comeback?
Yeah, no, I know. But I keep thinking about I lost my train of thought. Keep thinking about something.
Yeah, it'll come back to you. But yeah, I think one of the things that like hurts my soul the most is what AEW has done with the women's division, which is they've done nothing.
That was gonna be what I was gonna say is I feel like all the big signings in March, right? We had that had just happened, right? Like AEW was super hot because we're like, okay, there it's rumored to get Mercedes, it's rumored to get Okada, and then they had just signed Ospreay. So it was like all the promise in the world. And people, and at the time, the trolls and the tribalists were saying AEW is just gonna like go up, you know? But it's been down since those talents got added to the roster somehow.
Yeah. And the one who's like still had, because there's been some complaints now that Okada is not being used
Sure.
the way he should be.
Yeah.
There's been a lot of complaints about Mercedes' abilities now. Will Ospreay is the only one who like
People are happy with.
he's being like booked well. I don't, this is not a challenge, anyone who is booking anything for AEW, but it would be hard to screw that one up, like really hard. Granted, we've seen them do that before, but so again,
Yeah.
not a challenge, not a challenge.
I actually really like the angle with Okada and the Bucks.
Oh yeah, I like the new elite stuff.
I do too, but I also feel like in the last few weeks it just hasn't been hitting. Like it's been weird, you know? So I'm glad that Private Party, which is part of why I think that like they know they can tell that. And that's why they wanted to give the titles to Private Party. To get them off the Bucks because they're like, this is stale. We need to try something different. What's something we've never done before? Holy shit, Private Party's never had the titles, and people online are constantly pissed about that, you know, because they're AEW originals.
I'm just
But
saying, I also feel like things started to go downhill when they broke up the best friends. Just saying. Should have kept them together. I almost said Billy and Chuck. Wow. Chuck Taylor
Trent.
and Trent should be champs right now. Yes, I understand that Chuck Taylor has a career-ending injury, but still, but still.
I think that there's a lot of things like we could almost do an episode about this, though. What do we think is contributing to the current downfall of AEW? That could be an entire episode on its own. Like, I could almost say Jeff Jarrett being on the panel for the pre-shows that you don't watch contributes. And it's not that I hate Jeff Jarrett in that way, but it's like, it's to me, it exemplifies we've got too many cooks in the kitchen. You had a good formula with Renee and RJ. And then it feels like you're trying to pander to everybody. Now they have tons of guests on constantly during the pre-show. And it's like, it's great that you're giving people those experiences, but like they don't know how to operate in those capacities. They're either wrestlers who aren't trained, media trained like this. You know, like Renee's a pro. And then RJ is just like hilarious and like can roll with the punches. He's great at like on the fly, just rolling with whatever. But like then you throw people on there that just either want to talk about themselves or like, it's not engaging, you know?
I will say
So.
one of the things they are doing right is everything with Harley Cameron.
Oh, she's magic. Yeah.
Terrible.
Also, that cat makeup on her looked so good. It looks so good.
And I love, because like, I think she was also very cognizant of like, I don't want cultural appropriation. What can I do? I know a cat.
Yeah.
And it was
She's
just,
smart. She is smart as hell.
yep, she really is.
Yeah.
Alrighty. So then we have our last match of the evening, the AEW World Championship match, Jon Moxley versus Orange Cassidy. Who do you have, MJ?
Fuck. I already chose two new champions. This is where me not planning out my predictions is gonna bite me in the
Hey,
ass. Fuck.
sometimes they do that though in AEW. They're like, we're keeping everybody or we're tossing them all new belts.
I think Jon Moxley is gonna win because I think that they're gonna have a rematch and Orange Cassidy will win at World's End. But I also think Orange Cassidy could win. I don't know. This is so complicated.
I'm just letting everyone know right now. If,
Wait, where's World's End taking place?
oh, I have no idea. Not in Orange
Is it
Cassidy's home state.
going to be in New York or no?
No, it's not.
Oh, it's like in Florida, right? Isn't that the one that's like somewhere weird?
Yeah, it's in Orlando.
Oh, that's so weird. I was going to say that if it was in New York, then I was like, damn, maybe Daniel Garcia is going to win the TNT title at World's End instead. And then I could swap in Orange Cassidy. I don't know. Some of these are so up in the air for me.
I have Orange Cassidy winning. It's the reason I bought tickets. And if he does not win, this is completely a joke what I am saying for legal reasons. I will burn that arena to the ground. And all of New Jersey. Like it's hanging on by threads anyway. I'm from Pennsylvania.
Yeah, she is. Fuck, I keep going back and forth because my original prediction was that Orange is gonna win. And then as we were going through this, I was like, God, could it be Mox? Okay, I'm gonna lock in and say Orange. That puts me at three championship title changes, which is unlikely I will sweep.
I
This
mean,
might be my worst prediction ever.
there's a good chance of that because usually you do much better than I do, and we match on everything except for something. I don't
Oh
remember.
yeah, there was one thing. We were the same on the Costco
Oh, the
guy.
MJF match. That's it.
That's right. Fuck. I don't know. This whole honestly, you know what's throwing me off here is that this whole Mox thing has been so fucking weird. Because it was like ever since poor Danielson was just fucked up that you could tell they had to pivot the Mox thing sooner than they wanted to. They weren't ready for the transition. I feel like in Mox's initial promo, when they're like, "Why'd you do what you did?" It was kind of just like dancing around the, "I don't know why I did what I did."
Yeah. He was just like, they told me this last minute.
I know. I'm just rolling with the punches.
Right.
Yeah. So that's where I'm torn, is I could see them dragging this thing out to kind of make it the fluff up the storyline more. But I just could see Orange taking it. And a lot of people are talking shit online, go figure, about Orange Cassidy. They always call them pockets. You already know what they do. And I just
I
feel
block those
like
people, so no, I don't know what they do anymore. There is no Orange Cassidy that exists on my social medias. Like, I don't accept it.
I thought of you last night because I saw somebody's dumbass comment when they're like, "My man Mox is gonna take it. We're gonna make orange juice all over that mat." And I was just like, "What?"
It's like, sir, that sounds very homoerotic, everything you've just said.
Sometimes a lot of these comments do sound so homoerotic.
Oh,
And
yeah.
then I see them on other posts later where they're just like, "Why are trans people in sport?" And then I'm like, "Oh, now it all makes sense."
Oh, yeah. All righty. So those are our predictions. Let us know where you fall. And we'll know come Saturday who, if we're on the right train at all. I may never watch AEW again after.
I think I fucked this whole thing up. That's what I think.
My hopes hinge on all of one match, so.
Yeah. Honestly, you're gonna be in for a good show, though.
Yeah. My friend Andrew, that's going with me, he's also a big Orange Cassidy fan, so we're gonna be wearing our orange gear and fist fighting in the
Nice.
parking lot, you know, people who are saying anything about pockets.
So, are you going to be dressed as Orange Cassidy, both of you?
Oh no, I mean I'm just wearing a t-shirt.
Oh, okay. Got it. Got it.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
I mean, I'll probably be wearing jeans as well, so I mean kinda.
Yeah, right. I love it.
But not intentionally.
All right, lady. Anything else you want to add to the pay-per-view?
No, I think we are golden.
All right. Let's wrap it up with the name of our Lord and Savior,
Willow Nightingale.
the Babe with Power.
Power of voodoo, hoodoo, you do.
Nothing matters. Smile anyway.